Welcome to Sports Star Extras. My name is Lavanya. In this episode, we're going to be previewing the Women's T20 Challenge final between Harmanpreet Kaur Supernovas and Smriti Mandana's Trailblazers. This is also a repeat of the final league fixture, or the final round-robin fixture, if I may, between these two very sides. And that's a game we're going to be discussing on this episode as well. Now, of course, before we go ahead, you know the drill. Please make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. And while you're at it, press the bell icon so you do not miss a single episode from Sports Star. If we're going to discuss positives, I think Chamri Attapattu should be like a default positive, because her good run in this tournament continued even in this game versus the Trailblazers. She scored 67 of 48 runs, putting together about an 80-odd run stand for the first wicket with Priya Punia, which was great. Priya Punia was struggling. She scored a very laborious 30 runs out of, I think, 37 balls. And it was difficult for her to get going, but I think Chamri Attapattu really took on the weight of that partnership. And she got going where Punia could actually just spend time rotating the strike. So I think that was a huge positive for them, the fact that that opening order, that for that top order partnership really worked for this team. And that was what was lacking in their previous game versus Velocity. It was that one person in the top order who didn't click, so the owner sort of shifted again and again and again down the order. So that was something that this team managed to fix. Interestingly, Priya Punia, when she spoke to the broadcasters in that mid-innings break, she said the same thing. She's like, I was struggling to get the ball onto the bat. And at some point, I think Chamri just took off the load from me. And all I was trying to do was, okay, if I'm going to struggle to, you know, hit those shots across the park, I'm just going to focus on running. Good strategy, because it kept the run rate going. At one point, it really looked like this team was capable of getting to that 160-odd mark, because Chamri Attapattu was brisk. All she was doing was, yes, she was rotating the strike, but she was also making sure that she had a boundary going in there somewhere. And to be honest, I think the fact that batting was important for this side was also underlined in the fact that Harmanpreet Kaur promoted herself up the order and came in at number 3 rather than number 4. So she basically swapped with Jemima. And she did well for herself as well. She scored 31 of 29. Again, not the fastest of knocks that we'd expected to be. But good enough, because she managed to stabilize things when a wicket fell in this innings. A disappointment for the Supernovas, and something that they would want to focus on when they head into this final on Monday, would be Jemima Rodrigue's form. We can't afford to have her up there and not contributing to the order. If they have to face a lineup like the Trailblazers, they would definitely be licking their wounds, considering they didn't get the kind of bowling success that they had against Velocity. So that's something they definitely want to effect against the Supernovas in the final. Now, as far as the batting goes for the Trailblazers, I was a little disappointed, because chasing a target of 145, I think they had the firepower to chase this down well ahead of time. But that's something this team did not manage to do. Smriti Mandana, Deandra Dotton, they all got starts, but they weren't able to convert them into innings that would actually last all the way down. Having said that though, I think the bright spot for them would definitely be that late partnership between Deepti Sharma and Harleen Deol. Deepti Sharma managed to put up 43 of 40 balls, and Harleen Deol managed 27 in 15 balls, which is a lot more than you can say for the top order, which didn't really manage to get that, you know, sweet strike rate going. So the fact that they fell short by just 2 runs should show you just how close they were. It's funny, because I don't think at any stage of this match there was a point where the Trailblazers were in trouble, where they thought, oh no, we can't chase this down. They were decently comfortable all through, maybe for most part of the game except that last over, because they lost wickets then. And then it came down to Sophie Eccleston, who was facing her first ball in the last ball of the innings, and she needed 4 runs off that ball. So yes, heading into Monday's final, I think the one aspect that they would really want to look at is getting that batting order right and getting their performances together, be it chasing or setting a target. Deandra Dotton and Smriti Mandana would need to wake up to the fact that they are going to be the pivots around which this really folds out for them. And it would be wise to not leave it to the middle order or the tail to sort of save them if the need arises. The conditions in Sharjah have been a mixed bag so far. We've seen a game where both teams have decently managed to get going and find those runs, and we've seen games where the ball has been slow to come onto the bat. So to really assess what the conditions are going to be like on Monday and see how these two teams make use of those conditions or get crippled by them is going to make for a very interesting contest. Supernovas have been the most successful side, and Trailblazers will want to make sure that they don't walk away with the title this year as well. You can definitely join us in our coverage of the final. We're going to be live blogging this game. To keep up with that, you can log on to www.sportstar.thehindu.com. If you'd like to follow this game in between everything else that you're doing, you can follow us on social media at Sportstar Web on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. Or we can send you all of the updates from this game directly to your inbox. For that, you'll have to follow us on Telegram. I'll make the link available in the description of this video. We will be back with the review of the final and the Women's T20 Challenge as a whole. Until then, thank you for watching.